What's up, guys? In today's video, we're gonna be doing some more magnet fishing, and we are at a brand new spot. And guys, let me tell you, this spot looks so much better than any spot I have magnet fished here in Wisconsin. I don't know if you can tell, but we are literally like in, like, there's no houses for like a mile that way and a mile this way. I didn't see one when I was driving down here, and I checked on Google Maps, and it does not look like there's any remotely close. But look at this little creek that we have a bridge running over right here. Look at this. This thing looks so good. There's a little bit of current because we did have a little bit of rain last night, but we're going to give this a try. And this, I'm telling you, this looks very, very good. And then if this doesn't work, right here behind me, we have a railroad track. I think we have the potential to find a ton of stuff, not just off the railroad, but just like random things in general. If we don't get anything from the bridge part right here, I'm just gonna wander down to those rocks right there. I'm gonna throw the double-sided magnet and see if I can get some things from the railroad. So I'm about to set this thing down, go pick up the magnet. Let's go see if we can find some stuff.
Oh yeah, and by the way, when I say there's like literally nothing over here, I mean, look at this. There's literally nothing over here. I think there's a farm back there. There's a deer stand like right there. I don't know if you can see it, but we're gonna get back to the car and grab the magnet now.
Oh, look, there's a deer up there. The heck, it sounds like a freaking ghost. That's freaking cows. There's literally cows. Oh, there's more deer. Oh my gosh, there's so many deer over here. Those cows are hilarious. I just hear moo. Wait, I'm gonna try to communicate. Moo. Bro, he mooed back to me. That's hilarious. Oh, that felt magnetic. Oh yeah. First find of the day, literally on the first throw, pull it up. What do we have here? It looks like just a little piece to a sign. Man, I had to yank that thing out of the ground. Holy crap, look at that. First throw, guys. Guys, this could be a very good spot. There was a couple other things that I was like faintly sticking. Ow! Man, this rope's not as long as the other one. I forgot about that. We're gonna keep throwing here. That's a pretty good first find. That's like a quarter of a sign right there. Oh, man. Oh, man, right here. We got a sign. We got a sign. We got a sign. Get up here. Oh, man. Oh. We gotta twist it so it can come out the right way. Man, this thing's so heavy. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, there we go. Look at that. Oh, man. Holy crap, that was so loud. Look at that, though. We just had to yank that out of the mud. Look at that. Now, that is a piece to a sign right there. It's not the official sign, but look at that, man. That was so far in the mud. I clicked to it a couple times, and it did not want to come up. Holy crap, I can't believe it. That was literally like my third throw. I'm just gonna have to go really slow, I think, because I had to rip that thing out of the mud. That was down there for a while. Usually, me and Danny find one of these, like, I swear, like, every other day. Look at that. We have not found one of those signs yet in Wisconsin. Wait, what does this say? $25 to $100 fine or imprisonment for removing this sign. What? You could go to jail for if you take this sign off. What the heck? Wisconsin, okay. I definitely never seen one of those on there. Well, maybe that's why we don't see these in the water here. That kind of answered my question, actually. Hey, what are you in jail for? Oh yeah, I threw a sign in the water. We've taken a few throws on that side. Let's take a few throws on this side. I do wonder if I'm gonna get some stuff by this railroad track here. That's honestly one of the main reasons why I came to this bridge, was because the railroad track ran right next to it. And usually when railroads run over creeks like this, there's usually just so much stuff down there. We are gonna go back to the car and grab the double-sided magnet and actually get down there. We'll see if we can get something with the double-sided. Oh, there we go, we got a railroad spike. I knew we had to find something from the railroad. We're right under it. There you go, I was literally just about to switch spots here. But I think I'm gonna take a few more throws if I just found a railroad spike. Oh, I think we got something. Oh yeah, there we go. We just got a massive bolt. Look at that. A big old bolt. There we go. We're starting our pile. Maybe we can turn this day around here. I'm not gonna lie, I found those two things right away and then I haven't found anything since. Oh yeah, I have to have something. There's no way. Oh yeah, there we go. What the heck is this? Oh, it's two things. It's a railroad spike and a big washer. Look at that washer, man. That is huge. There we go. Pop that off and There we go, another railroad spike. Look at that. We're up to 1, 2, 3, 4 things right in this one spot here. Oh, this is a big thing. I just ripped it out of the mud. Oh boy, we got something big. We got something big. What is it? What is it? Oh, it's another square thing. Oh man. I found like a million of these at the last spot. Look at that. Another square thing to the railroad. Look how long that's been down there for. Look at all that. Oh my gosh. Look at that. I still don't know what these things are. So if you guys can let me know down in the comments. I know these are railroad spikes and I'm pretty sure they go like that. Right in there. Just like that. You know? I don't know. I could be wrong. That's crazy how much stuff we're finding right here. Railroads are like becoming like one of my new favorite spots to magnet fish. Oh yeah, there we go. We got another railroad spike. Holy crap. Look at how long that's been down there. Look at that. It's literally falling apart on the magnet. Holy crap. That's been down there for a long time. How do these things even end up in the water? I think we're gonna go look for a new spot right here just because this spot is really, oh, there we go. See, we're finding nothing but these railroad spikes. We gotta try to switch it up a little bit. It's getting a little repetitive to me. There is tons of stuff here, but I wanna find something different than railroad spikes all day, you know? So we're gonna go try to find another spot and hopefully it's good.
Yo, we just made it to the magnet fishing spot that we're gonna be trying, and look at this. This spot looks so good. We got a little, this is the spot that makes me the most excited about this. Sorry guys, I got this on a tripod right now. It's not really the most effective way to do this, but look at this spot right here. Oh, you're telling me there's not gonna be anything there? Look at that, there's a railroad bridge right there. Man, that looks so good. You guys can see over there through the trees, there's a big city right there. I don't know if you can see this. Buildings all over there, so I got some pretty good views. But this is gonna be my first time ever magnet fishing in a big city like this. I've never done this before, so this should be interesting. We'll see how that corresponds to like magnet fishing in rural parts of the state, because I mean, we literally started this video off magnet fishing in like rural Wisconsin. There was no houses on both sides for like miles. We're just gonna see if we find more stuff in the more populated area. I would assume so, right? It makes more sense, but we'll test that theory right now.
Oh, there we go. We got something here. What do we got? Out of everything, I catch a fishing lure. I catch a tube. Out of all the possibilities that I could catch something, I catch a tube. Well, there we go. We got a first find at this spot. We gotta stay positive here, right? We got a tube. Oh, there we go. Of course, you know, we get a railroad spike. Look at there. Let's throw like in the bridge ones. Let's throw in there. There's a pretty strong current that's coming out of here. Oh man, dude, there's so much stuff. I don't know why I'm not connecting to any of it. All right, there we go. We got something here. We got something there. Ah! Oh my God, guys, look at that. We got 3 railroad spikes on that throw. Holy crap, so many. Jeez, 1, 2, 3. We're up to 4 railroad spikes and we've taken like 3 throws. Let's throw there again. Oh yes, oh yes, oh that's big, that is big, that's gotta be, oh my gosh, what is this, what is this? Oh, are you kidding me, are you kidding me? It's another square thing, holy crap. Man, literally every railroad I go to, I find these things. Holy crap, look at that. I should bring a scale out one time and just weigh some of the stuff that I find, because you can't tell on camera how heavy it is. Well, duh. It is so heavy because it's just solid iron. That thing probably weighs 5-6 pounds. That was one solid click right there. Oh man, we got lots of stuff on that throw. Holy crap. All right, so we got a railroad spike. We don't really care about them, but what is this? What? I have no idea what this is. Can you let me know down in the comments what this is? Look at that. That's a cool find right there. What the heck? What is this? Oh, it's another one of those things. Oh wait, no, it's not. We got 2 railroad spikes. Man, there's so much stuff here. And one of these weird shaped pieces of metal. Man, we get these like at every railroad track too. I literally have no idea what they're used for though. Little weird shaped piece of metal there. Look at our pile though. We got a nice pile going already. Oh, do we have something? There we go. What the heck is this? It's like a screwdriver. Look at that. A little screwdriver. Look at that. You just screw it in, drill a hole right through the tree. Look at that. I don't think I've ever found a screwdriver like this before. Look at that. Cool, man. There we go. Threw that in the pile there. Man, I really want to try that. Oh, we got that big thing. We got that big thing. Oh, it's coming. What is it? What is it? Oh, get him. Oh, I just splashed my shoe. Oh, Oh, it's another one of those pieces, but this one is so much heavier. Oh man, I just soaked my shoes. Look at that. Ugh. Crap, let's flip this over. Man, look at how much bigger that is than that one. That's why it was heavier. I was like, man, that thing's so heavy. I really didn't think it was another one of these. I still have yet to know what these things are. It's crazy. I don't know why, but it's definitely, I think it's something to do with the railroad. Look at the pile we got for today. We got like probably about 10 railroad spikes, two of these big just chunks of iron, and then some random pieces of metal, man. This was a really good spot. I'm probably coming back here, taking my friend Magnificent for the first time, and you'll probably see that in next video. We're definitely coming to this spot. This spot right here turned out to be actually a very good spot where I'm coming back. Like, I'm literally just, I can look this way and that way, and I see two more spots that I can try. And I didn't even really give this a good enough try. So we are definitely coming back here tomorrow to do some magnet fishing here. There was so much stuff by that railroad track. I was not expecting to find that much stuff. And then the spot this morning, we found two bottoms of signs and a few pieces of the railroad track, which is crazy. But this spot has a bridge right there, another bridge over there. There's just so many good looking spots that we are coming back to, and hopefully we can find something different than some pieces of the railroad track. But anyways, I'll see you guys next. Whoa, where did that come from? I never said that before. But anyways, thanks for watching. See ya.